If science drops in a field, but no other researchers are around to hear it, does it further the academic area of study? Hey there, researchers. Trace here for DNews. Science is a process. It's a way of thinking about the world around us. Most of these scientific processes are thought through and then published in a journal, but to read them, you have to pay. Shouldn't all this scientific knowledge be free? Firstly, science is mostly paid for by grants from governments, nonprofits, foundations, universities, corporations, and others with deep pockets. We did a video about it. But even though the science was paid for, that's just the first half of the equation. The other half is the scientific journal. The first journals were published over 350 years ago as a way to organize new scientific knowledge, and that continues today. According to the International Association of Scientific, Technical, and Medical Publishers, 2.5 million new scientific papers are published each year in over 28,000 different journals. A new paper is published every 20 seconds. And you thought we'd run out of stuff for DNews. Researchers need others to read their paper so it can affect their field. So they freely send their treasured manuscripts to journals for peer review and publication. When a manuscript comes in, specialists select and send the best manuscripts to volunteer experts in the field who are, quote, carefully selected based on expertise, research area, and lack of bias, for peer review. After that, the papers are copy edited, compiled into an issue of the journal, physically printed, and then shipped or published online. They're like the nerdiest magazines in the world. And all of this costs money. According to a study in PLOS ONE, this whole process can cost between $20 to $40 per page, depending on how many papers the journal receives and how many they have to reject. Someone has to pay for that. And there are three ways this can happen. Authors can submit for free and readers, subscribers pay, called the traditional model, or authors pay and readers get it for free, called open access, or both authors and readers pay. English language journals alone were worth $10 billion in 2013. It's a big business. I know what you're thinking. Just put them on the internet. Save on the shipping, like newspapers and magazines. Well, even though publishers don't have to print and ship big books of papers anymore, they often still do. And even if the journals were only online, servers and bandwidth need to be paid for, and that ain't cheap. Plus, not everyone reads things on the internet. Publishing requires dollar bills, y'all, and someone has to pay, and everybody gets their money a little differently. For example, the American Association for the Advancement of Science, AAAS, they publish the science journals, and the Public Library of Science, PLOS, they publish PLOS ONE and a bunch of others. Both are nonprofits, but while PLOS uses an open access or free to you model, AAAS publishes 6 different journals, 5 with a traditional model of you pay and 1 with open access. Plus, there are for-profit journals like Macmillan Publishers, who own the journal Nature and have a mix of traditional and open access options. The giant Reed Elsevier, now called RELKS, publishes over 2,000 journals, some of which are open access and some are traditional. So though some of these are nonprofits, they don't always give it to you for free. They can still charge researchers up to $2,900 to publish, and others, the for-profits, they make money off of scientific research, which makes some people feel icky. The whole thing is confusing, and nobody does it the exact same way. So asking what is worse, for-profits, charging universities or readers for access, or open access, charging the authors, the debate rages. It's a big old shrug. Many scientists argue, as the peer review is provided for free by the scientific community, and the papers are provided for free by the scientific community, then access to those papers should be free. The EU agrees, ordering any publicly funded papers to be made free by 2020, pushing toward that open access to science. In the US, where many of these papers originate, some scientists are calling for boycotts on for-profit publishers. In the end, there was a time when practitioners needed a physical reference to the latest scientific achievements. In the days before the internet, getting a journal in the mail must have been both exciting and illuminating. But now, thanks to digital publishing, this whole pay-for-science model, it's want to change. People want the knowledge to be free, but no one knows how to do it. As you know, more research is always needed, but should that research be behind a paywall? Let us know down in the comments. Make sure you subscribe so you get more DNews every day. You can also come find us on Twitter, @Seeker. But for more on how much science actually costs, watch this video.